Dent, Professor Mahmoud Dent-Bayou, and Professor Mahmoud, he's also associate professor here at the NRC, and he's part of the flagship membrane group. And he will present the development of a pilot scale phase inversion-based membrane casting machine. And well, perhaps this will also give some answers on economics in polymeric membranes when this pilot scale is already solved and then going to industrial scale. So please, again, you have 15 minutes, yeah, and then we will interrupt you.
This lecture is about the development of pilot scale phase inversion based membrane casting machine. This machine was produced at National Research Center through help in research of inversion based membrane casting project. First, what is phase inversion technique? Simply, it starts by the doping solution. A doping solution is brought on a piece of glass, either with a substrate or not. And then this layer is immersed in coagulation liquid, usually water, and the result is a flat sheet membrane. As usual, it could be done in different ways. This is how it is done manually. And in this picture, it is how it is done with it is drawn hand manually with the banana, but on a substrate. In this photo here, this is how it is done with a drawing machine. This is an A4 drawing machine. This is usually the normal size of drawing machine, small one. It is drawn then held by hand and immersed in the coagulation tank. The motivation of the current machine was the need to produce membranes with repeatable properties. When you do manufacture it, draw it manually, immerse it manually, you get different properties for the same composition of the membrane. So we need to produce the membranes with the same composition to give us the same properties. There was actually, and again, the need to produce membranes of size suitable for pilot testing. Usually the A4 membrane is not suitable to produce a module to test it in a pilot scale. They need to produce a large number of membranes. We usually need to experiment with composition of membranes to find out the best composition. So we need a machine that can produce a lot of membranes in a quick way. Again, there was a need to locally adapt the required technology. And the machines in Egypt is usually double price its cost approach. The machine, there was decided a general guide for the machine. First, it should have controlled operation. It should be low cost. It shouldn't cost much. The cost of the machine operation should be low. No cost of machine maintenance and ease of operation. So anyone will be able to operate it easily. Ease of maintenance and availability of repair requirements. And this is actually, most of the machines in Egypt has this particular problem, the repair part or spare part. Ease of future development. When you produce a machine, you can develop it farther and farther and farther and farther. While if you just buy it, you need to buy another one and buy another one. And this is a problem, at least financially. There was a specific guideline for the machine. The cast size itself, it should be within the pilot sizes. The control of drawing speed, we need to control the drawing speed, we need to control the drawing thickness of the membrane, we need to control the time between drawing the membrane and immersing the membrane. Just in some membranes, you need to let it settle for a while before immersing in the coagulation liquid, and this time actually changes properties of the membrane. So we needed to control that time. We need to control the inertial speed itself. If you immerse it in a wrong way or a very high speed, you'll get the sheet disturbed and you'll not get a consistent properties all over the sheet. We need to control the inertial time, and this is of course the after you immerse the membrane, you need to let it coagulate for some time. And this time will give you how much it was coagulated. You need to control this immersion time. Elimination of human factors, we talked about it before. When you include the human factors in the production process, you always get the hallmark of human factors, errors, or variations. Due to the rate of production, we need to produce a large number of things within good time scale. This is stemmed from one lovely note from the friends who are involved with the chemical part, that they will need up to 24 hours of immersion for the membrane in the coagulation liquid to get the full coagulation. Of course, you can't leave the machine stand still for 24 hours just for one sheet. So we managed to solve this problem as well, as we talked about it here. The machine was decided to have two main subsystems: machine structure, which consists of the machine body, and the drawing system, which is the system that's gonna draw convert the liquid into a flat sheet on the glass. On the glass sheet, drawing system, this is the immersion system, the system that will take this glass sheet and immerse it in a controlled way into the coagulation bag. And there is the motion system. The motion system consists of three parts: the control unit that is going to control all this motion, and the motor that's going to cause or affect the motions, and accessories, components that will connect the motors and the control unit and the mechanical structure of the machine. Here is a drawing for the design that we've reached after the research about this on these old guidelines. We had to put all these guidelines into work to find a good design that will satisfy these guidelines. And here's a detailed drawing with dimensions of the machine that was designed. The machine was built, and here is the final machine that we managed to build them. We'll talk about what this machine is about in the coming slides. The machine consists of only, this is the mechanical system above, and this is the drawing unit. And here is this mechanism back there, we'll show it. It is an immersion system with the four bar mechanisms here that support that glass sheet that will hold the membrane, on which that membrane is going to be cast. Here is the casting glass. The membrane will be casted, will be cast with this glass sheet. And here is the immersion tank, of coagulation tank. The membrane size here, we are talking about 60 centimeters in width and 110 centimeters in length, which is suitable for producing modules. So this is the pilot scale membrane. The drawing unit consists of this a small tank here that moves along the glass, the sheet of glass. It moves, but as it is supported by a guide wheel on the right and another one on the left. And it moves under the effect of a belt that on the side of the machine. And actually we have two belts, one on the right side and one on the left side too, to make the motion more smooth. Here is the motor that affects this motion, and it is located in a separate compartment within the machine, and here is the bit that gives the motion, and we can realize, we can have a look here that this is a timing though, to make sure that the speed is well controlled without sticks. And here is limit switches to make sure that the machine will not jump its ends, will not get out of the track. And we managed to do a nice trick with these limit switches. We used normally closed switches to make sure that the machine will always not jump the ends by under even the fault conditions. If the wires were totally cut, even then the machine will just stop without motion until you fix it. But normally, the normally open switches would require that you push the button first to open the circuit so the motor would stop. Now here, anything including fault will stop the motor. And here is the two motors. A look for an overview of the two motors connected in the compartment. And here is the inertion unit. In the inertion unit, there is a bar connected on a power screw with a sprocket. Another sprocket on the inertion motor connected with a chain. When the motor rotates the chain, then the other sprocket, then the power screw will move this bar forward and backward, guided by these guideways to the right and the left. And here is the four-bar mechanism under an intermittent state between being up and down. This is in the middle. These two bars, we can have a look on the previous slide. Mm-hmm. On this slide, when this bar moves forward, it pushes this link here, and this link is connected to the carriage that holds the glass sheet. So it pushes it forward or backward. And this motion here is another view of it. This is the bar, the connecting rods here, and connecting the inertion. The bar here, the guided bar, so it pushes forward and backward, holding at the end the carriage. The carriage is supported on four connecting rods. This is two of them. The front ones are smaller, were designed smaller than the, or shorter than the back ones to make a slant in the motion. So the front part of the of the membrane would go down faster than the backward one, and this motion allows the water not to splash while you're immersing the glass sheet into the coagulation bath. And so here, the front is actually lower than this part here. It's small angle, so at least in this stage, but it is it gets more. So it immerses the front, the rest, then gradually goes the back of the glass sheet. Here is the motor with its sprocket, and here are the guideways connecting and the connecting rod here, and these are the two limit switches that will make sure that that this carriage will not go over its ends. And here is the control unit. This is just a shield of the control unit. The control unit was just had a lot of nice features. Were designed specifically for the local market. Just two buttons, and everything is done. This is the home. You press the home. You put the liquid. Press the start, and all the process goes forward under the program conditions. So it needs to be programmed once, then it's just home, but directly press start. So this is the automated mode. But sometimes someone would require or want to be a bit more into control. So we have a semi-automated mode for this machine, two joysticks, one would push it forward and backward, and one would push, would get it immersive or get it up. And under the same, under different conditions here, the same thing. You program the conditions that you want for the speed of drawing or the speed of immersion. Why did we do that actually? Sometimes they told me, we don't want you to cast to draw with this dotted down. We want to control the time ourselves. So I have to split the two from each other, at least in a different mood. So they can cast it the way they like it, then they can leave it how long they want, then they can immerse it whenever they want, and get it up whenever they want as well. And this is the last mode of operation for the machine. We made through this sprocket, we can rotate the sprocket, and we can rotate this bar, the crossbar here, that would, and this bar here. When you rotate this one, you affect the drawing motion. Rotating clockwise will make it to draw, rotating counterclockwise will get it backward. On the other side here, the inertia, you rotate it clockwise and it immerses the carriage, rotate it counterclockwise and gets up. And for solving the problem of 24 hours of coagulation, we've managed to make an external storage tank. Looks like normal storage tank with nothing unique about it, but actually there is a very, very unique structure here. This structure allows us to put 10 glass sheets over each other, not touching, in the same tank without any moving parts. It allows through this sortive light, you engage the sheet into one of these sortive, and then put it here. It will rest on one of these steps, allowing preventing it from going out of the sortive here, and preventing it from touching the previous sheet down. So this was a nice achievement. Actually, this storage tank can take 10 sheets at the same time, not touching each other. You can take them out, put another one in with no problem. Result of this research stemmed into the production of this machine. The machine itself started production in 2015, and up to this date, it produced 6,000 membranes, and it's located now at the Ethiopian National Research Center with the flat and the property of flat sheet membrane group. And it's still in working condition after 4.5 years of operation. And here is a set of membranes produced, a sample of membranes, membrane modules, flat sheet membrane modules produced by membranes cast by this machine. And here is another set of modules. And this machine, and this is a list of papers, of example of papers that the machine actually contributed to these papers. Here's five papers that it contributed to their functionality, which proves actually the functionality of the machine and its capacity to engage in active research activities. And the machine itself has a patent, an Egyptian patent, number 29086, and it's ready to serve. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Professor Mahmoud. I think it's quite interesting because when you have this pilot plant now for 4 years and produce 6,000 membranes, yes, you have a weekend and so on, but that's round about 5 membranes produced per day. For industry, that's almost nothing, but for pilot scales, this is really, really tough work. So thank you very much. And are there any comments or questions? You.
The control system, yes.
And you have the setting of all
question is about the control system. Is it open control or closed loop control? Actually, we managed to get both the benefit of both worlds. Open loop control is cheap and very convenient, but low quality of control. And closed loop is quite precise, but very high in price. We use these motors. It's called stepper motors. Stepper motors are actually digital motors. So they have the capacity to offer the performance of closed loop control while they are working on an open loop control strategy. So it is an open loop control with the precise control of the closed loop control system. No, there's no feedback at all.
So it's an open?
No, it is an open, but these models deliver a quality of closed loop control and open loop control.
The setting of the velocity of the drawing depends on what?
What, sorry?
The setting of the velocity of the drawing. Depends on what?
These motors are not actually normal motors that you just feed them electricity and they operate. No, they actually receive a train of pulses. Every motor of them have 8 wires, and it receives different pulses of different wires. And the rate of these pulses...
And you and Dr. Abdelaziz from the same department, you can have more discussions about our machine and the machine you have written, because Dr. Mahmoud is it. Professor of Mechanical Engineering and one of the team designed this machine, and one of the of them, if they get a patent, granted patent from Egyptian grantee office, and I think you more detail, mechanical details, we can't understand it, so you can make this detail in your department. Thanks a lot. We will move forward.